Hey guys, Dr. Christy Ennis. Today we are going to go over 4 hamstring exercises that you can do right at home without any equipment except some fancy schmancy socks. And they're going to help prevent some knee pain and prevent actually hamstring injuries from occurring. Now these exercises are going to start from the easiest and go harder, so make sure you follow along. Also, keep in mind that these are what we call eccentric exercises, meaning they are the lengthening portion of the muscle, which is important because that is where the muscle tends to be weakest. And that a lot of times is why people that have had a hamstring injury just keep re-injuring it because they haven't strengthened it effectively. So let's get started on that first one. I'm going to use a chair to hold on to because sometimes my balance is off. But you're going to take the lead leg and you're going to come up on the heels. Sometimes it's easier if you use a towel instead of a sock, but the sock works pretty well too. All right, so keeping nice and upright, I'm going to take this back leg, and it's okay to be on the toe, and I'm going to, whoops, there we go, wax on, wax off, I'm kind of off, slide it back, and then pull, you're using that front leg to pull it back forward again. So don't go too far, or you'll end up doing a split, which is not this video, but really think just kind of pull it in, and you're really trying to use that hamstring that's in the front leg. Shoot for 10 repetitions of these if you can. For the next one, another standing one, again, use a chair, something sturdy. If you need to hang on, if not, work on your balance. Foot is going to be pointing straight forward. The foot that's on the ground or the leg that's on the ground is really the leg that's doing the work. Slight bend in that knee. I'm going to shift my hips back and keep my back flat, not lifting this leg. It's just coming up for the ride, and then come on up. To challenge yourself, we'll see if I can do this today, you can even add a little reach across, right? So now we're working on a little bit of a different angle of those muscles. There's more than one hamstring muscle. You can reach to the other side, but don't let this leg rotate open. Otherwise, you're not using that standing leg the way that you need to, okay? Going down onto the ground for the next two. And I'm actually going to roll this up because I need these socks again. Fortunately, I actually have the left one on the left and the white one on the right today. So you're going to go into a bridge. Make sure you're keeping that neutral spine. You're going to walk those legs out without dropping your hips as far as you can. Ooh, that's about it for me right now. Take your time with this one. Don't go out too far. You always want to start wherever you are. There's no one spot that you have to be. Always remember that, okay? And again, walking out as far as you can without dipping or shifting, and then coming back. 10 repetitions there too, if you can. The last one is definitely the hardest. I'm going to take a nice deep breath here. One leg. So I'm actually going to come up on the heel just a tiny bit, slide that one leg out without letting my hips drop. Whoa. And don't cramp in your hamstring either, right? So slide and back in. Show you with my other leg, just in case you couldn't see that. Slide and back in. Okay, that is the hardest, and I can totally feel that. So there you have it. Start with that first one. If it's too easy, go ahead and progress through till you get to that last one. And if 10 is too easy, go for 2 sets of 10. Woo, you can do it. I believe in you. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, click that thumbs up button. Thanks, guys.